welcome to the very first episode of East Valley Teacher News. I hope this video finds you and your family safe and healthy in the comfort of your own home. I'm your host, Mr. Saratori, and before we start, I should clarify, what is East Valley Teacher Updates? Now that's a great question. East Valley Teacher Updates is a collection and a broadcast of all of the amazing things that your teachers at East Valley High School have been doing during this quarantine time. I think you're going to find that some of the things that they found to stay busy are not only amazing, but also inspiring. We here at East Valley High School hope that these videos and this news broadcast makes you smile and maybe even laugh. Enjoy. So, let's get it started off with our first story ever on East Valley Teacher Updates. Our first video was submitted by our very own school counselor, Mr. Hales. Ooh, jeez! His video was submitted through TikTok, and it's a video of his daughters doing a boogie in the backyard. It's pretty awesome. Check it out. That was pretty awesome. Great job, ladies. And thank you, Mr. Hales. Now, before we get to our next story, I have to clarify something. I know a lot of you viewers at home are wondering, is Mr. Saratori doing the classic thing where he's wearing a suit on top and he's wearing shorts or pajamas or something else on the bottom? You're absolutely right that I am not wearing a suit pant. I am wearing shorts. Now let me show you. So, as I just explained, I am wearing a suit on top. This is to maintain professionalism. However, because you can only see the top part of my body, okay, I am wearing shorts on the lower half. Check it out. I have shorts on and socks. Wait a minute. Look at my socks. There's a hole in one. Speaking of a hole in one, our next story comes to us from Mr. Cosper, who won a virtual home golf tournament from his very own living room. He shot 3 times, and, well, check out just how great he did. Wow, Mr. Cosper, that was pretty awesome. 2 for 3, pretty impressive. But how did you get so many people packed into your living room to be cheering and booing you on? It's almost like someone had way too much time on their hands this week and decided to edit all of these videos and add special sound effects. I mean, really, who has the time to do that sort of stuff? It's pretty pathetic, if you ask me. Anyways. As teachers, we can all agree that notes are extremely important in school. But sometimes the notes don't necessarily have to be pen and paper writing down or typing them on your computer. Sometimes some musical notes are what we need to have in our lives. This next story comes to us from a very important member of the East Valley community. Mr. DeRay has a very, very special surprise for all of you viewers. Check it out.
So this shout out, Mr. Saratori actually recommended or asked me if I'd do something a little bit different and play a song. I'm way out of practice. It's been a couple months since I've really played much or sang much, but I'm gonna do it for you guys. So this song is by a band called Incubus, one of my all-time favorite bands, and the song is called Drive. And if you listen to the lyrics real closely, it's about meeting life's challenges head on, without fear of failure, about being positive as you face those challenges. So if you guys have been around me, you know that's something I preach pretty regularly, so pretty fitting right now. So figured I'd play the song for you. Hope you guys enjoy it. I'll try not to screw it up too bad. Again, like I said, I'm way out of practice, so anyway, bear with me, but here we go. Sometimes I feel the fear of uncertainty stinging clear, and I can't help but ask myself how much I let the fear take the wheel and steer. It's driven me before, seems to have a vague, haunting mass appeal. Lately, I'm beginning to find that I should be the one behind the wheel. Whatever tomorrow brings, I will be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I will be there, I'll be there. So if I decide to wait for my chance to be one of the hive, would I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive? It's driven me before, seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. Lately, I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my life is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I will be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I will be there, I'll be there. Would you choose water over wine? Hold the wheel and drive. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there, I'll be there.
Our next story comes to us from our other social studies teacher, Mrs. Knapp. Mrs. Knapp and her daughter Emma have achieved something remarkable. I'm not going to spoil what that is. Just check it out.
Say hi, everybody.
Excellent job, Emma. And thank you, Mrs. Knapp, for sharing such an incredible moment with all of us. Now, to cap off this episode, we have something very special for you. Your teachers have gone out of their way to send you all a very important message. Check it out.
Hey, everyone. Just wanting to check in with you. Give a big shout out to Mr. Saratori for getting this set up. Seniors, love you guys. I know it's been a rough few weeks, and it's a rough way to end your senior year. Know that we believe in you, and I know that you guys are going to be able to get through this and accomplish great things in your lifetimes.
Hey, Red Devils, Mr. Dre here. So Mr. Saratori asked staff to record some shout outs to you guys so we can put together a video letting you guys know that we're thinking about you, we miss you. This whole working from home thing really sucks. It's hard to get used to. It's hard to stay motivated. Anyway, we're here for you guys. This next couple months is gonna be really challenging, but we're here to help you get through it. Just want you guys to work hard, do your best, and let us know if there's any way we can help.
Hey there, all you cool cats and kittens. It's Mrs. Torpy. Just wanted to let you all know how much I miss you and to remind you all to wear your ID badges during school hours. I've been spending a lot of time with my computer and my kids, and I already want to suspend all of them, but I don't have anywhere to send them. So miss you guys. It's still a great day to be a Red Devil. Bye.
Hey, Red Devils. Welcome to the Morrison House / classroom.
We miss all of you guys, even you, sixth period.
Well, since we've been on this lockdown here, I have coached an undefeated softball season, gotten a haircut. Most of you can't do that.
I cut his hair, just so you know. I've been doing a lot of cooking since we have a little more time. And speaking of cooking, if you've ever had brownies at a movie night or a team dinner for the Morrisons, here's all you have to do.
Just go to Costco. They're not homemade.
I make them at home. It's okay. We miss you guys. I'm sorry that we're all stuck at home. It could be worse. You could be Javen with two of your teachers in your house. Take care.
Love you guys. Miss you.
But we don't want to see you in the park. Bye.
What's going on, Red Devils? Assistant Principal Mr. Martone here. Wanted to say hello. I got my official attire on. Professional tie, sweatshirt and sweats, which I know all of you are in. I got my hat. Big shout out to the baseball team. And I am growing my hair out. Didn't know it was possible, but it is. Just want to say that we all care about you. Please continue to work hard on your academics and continue to communicate out with those teachers. The teachers are working super hard. I'm talking to them every single day, and they want you guys to be successful this year. Have a great day. It's a great day to be a Red Devil. Talk to you guys soon.
Well, this wraps up our very first episode of East Valley Teacher Updates. I hope you had fun. I hope you enjoyed it. It was very fun for me to make, and I know a lot of the teachers enjoyed sending in things. We plan to do this every week, so please tune in next week for our second episode. This is Mr. Saratori signing off. Have a great day. Adios.